Hey guys, it's Rebecca. Thank you so much for joining me for today's video. Today's video is going to be a repressing of my Panda palette for 2021. I think the last time I did a repressing Panda palette was last year for my Minnie Mouse by Sephora. Did I pan that last year? It feels like it's been a longer time than last year, but whenever I pan that palette, I did a repressing sort of video whenever I had just a few shades left, and you guys have seen my latest update. If you haven't, this is what my palette is looking like right now. It hasn't changed much, a little bit, maybe a little bit of sin has disappeared a little more, but I was just going to repress it, but I figured whenever I use these two shades over that brown cream shade, they kind of tend to look similar. So in order to add a little bit more variety into my look and avoid me getting bored by looking the same way every single day while I use these two shades, I decided to Franken repress this palette, and I'm gonna take you guys on the journey with me. So I'll just probably repress in the middle, and then these two I'll Franken shade somehow. I really don't have a plan. I'm just going to take you guys along for the ride with me and see what we come up with. But Sin is the only thing that I'm planning on repressing by itself, and this shade will not last very long in my palette. Polyester Bright, you guys can finally see a little bit better what it looks like. The pan, I have side pan as well. And then I have side pan on Shattered way up here. So yeah, I'm going to be repressing this. The palettes that I'm going to work, incorporate into with these refrankens are these two palettes. I have the Naked Basics from Urban Decay. This is the first one. And so far, this is what this guy is looking like. I have finished these two shades, Hit Pan on Walk of Shame. Naked 2 is still brand new, but I've been using Faint as my brow shade recently. I know these are not the most interesting shades to incorporate into a refranken, but this palette and this other Sephora palette, they're both in my products I want to use up in 2021. So I figured if I was going to incorporate eyeshadows, might as well have them be from these two palettes. So we'll see where we come up with there. And then this one from Sephora, or how do you open this? There it is. I have used up one shade, this one right here. This was a cream shade that I used last year, maybe, I think. That's why it has an X. But the other five shades are basically untouched. They've only been swatched, and that's what they look like right now. Again, not the most interesting colors, but we'll make it work.
Make it work.
So let's see. Let's see what we come up with. So first I decided to start with Sin. I figured I wasn't going to be refrankening that with anything else. So I figured might as well just start with that one. That would be the easiest one to start with. And basic repressing, crush it up, add your alcohol, and then press it with your finger with a paper towel. And it repressed pretty well. Then I moved on to Mildew, which is that olive green shade. I repressed only half of it because I didn't want to ruin the whole shade in case the whole thing just turned out to be a complete mess. And I added a little bit of the white shade as well. And then I added a little bit of the that peachy shade from that Sephora palette. And then I added it onto the little pan there that's right next to it. I went ahead and I mixed it everything up, and then I added a little bit of alcohol. Once I finished mixing it up, I felt like it was looking very similar to Mildew, probably because it, you know, the consistency was wet. So I decided to add a little bit of that cream shade from that Naked Basics palette. It honestly didn't do much to lighten it. You guys will see that in the final product, but I did add. Ended up adding a little bit of that shade, mixed it in there really well. As you guys can see, it didn't really lighten the shade much, but I ended up just repressing it like so, and you guys will see the finished product right there. I decided to just go ahead and repress Mildew in its own pan. That way I have kind of a full pan to work with. This ended up being very, very thin in the pan, so I feel like if I focused on it this month, I'll have this one finished no problem. So I repressed it, pressed it as hard as I could, and there you have it. Then I moved on to, I forget the color of the blue one, I can't see. Shattered. I did the same thing. I repressed only half of it, again, not wanting to mess up the whole thing. And I added a chunk of the white as well to this shade, also hoping to make it lighter than the blue itself. Then some of the peach shade from that Sephora palette. And for some reason, I decided to add some of the brown chunk from the Urban Decay palette as well. That was a lot of product. As you guys can see, it almost filled the whole pan of that palette. Added the alcohol very, very carefully because I didn't want to overspill it. And for some reason, it ended up looking very similar to the Franken from Smog. I was very frustrated because I remember that happening with that Mickey Mouse palette. The re-Franken shades look very similar. Anyway, I moved on to Mildew and, Shattered, and I repressed it. And also Polyester Bright, I figured might as well just repress everything. Again, I just wanted the palette to look nice. And even now that I was in a repressing mood, pretty basic repressing here. You guys know the drill. Mix all the colors really, really well. I ended up getting a little bit of blue in that white shade, but once I use it, I think it won't change the whole pan too drastically. But as you guys can see, there's a tiny bit of blue in the white. So that's what the repressed product looks like. I left it out in the sun for a little bit. And as you guys can see in the picture, this is what the product looked like. I have the repressing that's looking very, very similar. The first left shade, that is the, the dark shade, the green one, the olive green one. Then the second shade is that re-Franken. The third shade is Shattered, the blue one. And then the fourth shade is the re-Franken. So, I mean, the both re-Frankens look exactly the same. We'll see how they look like once I apply it on my eyeball, but not my eyeball, my eyelids. And hopefully, I don't know, I'm probably going to have to end up repressing one of them again. Maybe I'll have to move on to another palette and add a more colorful shade, maybe a yellow or a red or something. But yeah, those colors did not look like how I originally had planned. But what are you going to do? That's the whole purpose of re-Frankening. You're experimenting, and eventually I'll get use of my shadows. But that is it, guys. I hope you guys enjoyed this quick little repressing update. Thank you so much for watching, and I'll see you on the next one. Bye.